There you are. You've spoken with the survivors.
Indeed. We thought to share what we have gleaned, that we might together gain a greater understanding of present circumstances.
Fortuitous timing. Alizé and I completed our own investigations not long ago.
Then we should take a moment to compare notes. Shall we begin with the two of you?
So the merchant Karzal was gravely concerned about his business in the days preceding his untimely end.
The tales we heard were much the same. The first victims to be changed into blasphemies were all overcome with anguish of one manner or another. Then those who saw their loved ones stolen before their eyes succumbed to a similar panic, setting in motion a chain of transformations.
Fear, unease, despair. These negative feelings serve as a catalyst.
If so, then it is not unlike the calamity that befell the ancients. With their creation magics, they unwittingly gave form to untold horrors. Had they simply lost control, surely it would have manifested in many forms, not all of them monstrous. Yet somehow, this phenomenon is triggered solely by the darkness in their hearts, a common thread with what we now witness.
Common, but not identical. While the beasts the ancients faced were forged with magic alone, those of today are born of sentient beings. Why remains to be seen. But there is one fundamental difference between us and our predecessors. Our souls are sundered, whereas theirs were not. Perhaps that single variable makes all the difference.
If I may, there was another detail that troubled me. We have it on good authority that Karl Zahl's transformation took place before the skies began to burn.
What? If that's true, then the situation's more dire than we realized. It means even if there's no ominous sign presaging the final days, anyone, anywhere, has the potential to become a beast. Even in lands we thought safe, even as we speak.
Look! It's the Satrap! The Satrap!
Thank the heavens!
My countrymen, I am relieved and heartened to see you strong and safe. While the danger has not yet passed, far from it, allow me to assure you that the beasts that raged within the city walls have been exterminated to the last. Outside this sanctuary, the brave men and women of the Radiant Host and our dragon ally continue to battle our unholy foes. I pray these tidings put your minds at ease and help you calm your hearts. Have faith that we shall soon conquer this terrible trial.
Your Excellency, is there any word from Palaga's stand? My grandson was bound for there yesterday, and I worry for his life.
We are still awaiting a report, but I promise you, as soon as I have aught to share,
Your Excellency,
I bring grave news.
You are?
I'm Matsya of Akyali, a humble fisherman.
Ah, I remember you from our first visit.
Wait, you're... But no, that can wait. When the skies turned red, I set off for Palaka's stand, fearing for the safety of a friend. But as I drew near the village, I saw dreadful beasts all about.
No! Gods have mercy! Your Excellency! Save my grandson, I beg of you!
We will spare no effort to save all we can, but you must remain calm.
Calm? You tell me to be calm? You saw those beasts? They tore our bravest warriors limb from limb! What if we are too late, huh? Did they catch him? Stick their fangs into him? The fangs!
Get away from her, now!
Them before it spreads.
We'll handle this. See the townspeople to safety.
Run! As fast as you can!
Oh!
Be strong, my friends! Fear not, for we will defeat these abominations! Brave men and women of the Radiant Host, lend your stoler and Thancred your aid. Let not a single beast escape. The rest of you, flee this place. Carry the wounded if you must. Head indoors or underground. Above all, stay calm. No beast will follow you. We will see to that.
Alphino! Alize! Leave the city to us and make for Palica's stand at once! Matya, show my friends to the village! I promise you, they're more capable than the host's finest!
Right!
Go with them, will you? We will save these people, as many as we can.